Alright, here we go. Is that it? Is that it? You play? Here we go, you play. Good morning, church. It's good. The job's not plugged in yet. Thank you. 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
Yeah. it's the Spirit of God saying to us that we've got to put on the garment of praise for a spirit of heaviness. Can I say this morning, there are some versions when you read that scripture, it says put on the garment of praise instead of the spirit of heaviness. There are people this morning that came into the house. You have clothed yourself in heaviness. You are lifting your hands and you are singing the words, but you are clothed with heaviness. This morning the Lord says to you, come, because I want to change your heaviness to praise. If you are here this morning, He's saying to you this morning, I need you to change your perspective. You have glorified your problem so big, and you have made your God so small. I don't know who I'm speaking to this morning, but this morning God wants to give you a garment of praise. As this worship team leads us further into the presence of God, where you are, I want you to raise your hand. The chains that bind you, hallelujah, you need to replace it with the garment of praise this morning. God is here to break the chain of heaviness this morning. He wants to give you the faith that you need. He wants to set you free this morning. Hallelujah.
Go. says this: when I look at your heavens and the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the son of man that you care for him? Church, when we sing hallelujah, do you know what that means? It means praise the Lord. Who are we? And I don't mean this to be self-loathing. I don't mean this to make us look low at ourselves, but rather to put us into a place of worship and humility. Who are we that the God of the universe would look upon us this morning and take delight in the praises and the worship? And the answer to this question, who are we? The answer is, it's not about us. In Exodus 34, it says this. It's about Moses wanting to see the glory of the Lord. And this is his glory, church. The Lord, a God merciful and gracious. He is slow to anger. He is abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness, keeping steadfast love for thousands of generations. He is forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, but who will by no means clear the guilty. Church, he is just. And at the same time, he is graceful and merciful to us. And I don't want to let this moment go by, but church, I tell you, look upward and look to our God. That some of us, yes, are in here with a spirit of heaviness. Some of us are singing these words and our heart is dull. But I tell you, church, come with a heart of worship and praise, that we are people who do not deserve it. And yet, he comes to us and he says, I will show you grace. I will show you mercy. I will show you love. And for you, you may not feel it. But I tell you, church, even